What's up, guys? Welcome back. It is summertime, and that means summertime grilling. So for this video, I thought it might be fun to try messing around with barbecue charcoal and high voltage electricity. Now for this experiment today, I'm bringing back my neon sign transformer. This lovely little unit converts house power to 12,000 volts, 30 milliamps, which isn't a whole lot of power, but it is very high potential, which will definitely make you squirm if it touches you the wrong way. Now, if you've ever really studied your charcoal briquettes, you'll probably realize that they're just pyrolyzed wood. Of course, there are a few other components added in to help with your barbecuing experience, but for the most part, this is just compressed pyrolyzed sawdust. Now, since we have access to 12,000 volts of electricity and a piece of wood, I want to show you something kind of interesting. If we take our two high voltage electrodes and touch one to the piece of wood and then bring in the other one, you'll notice absolutely nothing happens at all. That's because wood is not conductive, or should I say, it's not very conductive. Everything has a dielectric breakdown, but wood is very difficult to pass an electric current through. If I bring the electrodes themselves close enough together, they'll eventually strike an arc on their own, and the heat produced from the arc will actually scorch the wood and begin to char it. As that char develops and the carbon goes deep enough, eventually it will develop an electrically conductive path, that when I bring the two electrodes close to that, it lights up a path that kind of resembles lava flowing down the side of a volcano. The only difference is this is electricity flowing through the wood, not lava. Let's keep this going a little bit and see how far we can push it. And I can actually draw that pathway out all the way to the side of the wood. There, that's pretty cool. So that's pretty cool. Wood by itself is not conductive, but once you burn it a little bit, you can actually conduct electricity through it, or at least through the carbon path that you created within it. And this is actually a well-known fact hundreds of years ago, back when Thomas Edison was developing the light bulb, because he actually used pyrolyzed bamboo as the filament for his light bulb. So here's the question I have today. If we can get burnt wood to conduct electricity so well, then what would high voltage electricity do to charcoal? I mean, theoretically, this stuff is basically just carbon, so it should be conductive, right? So for this first experiment, I'm going to take this piece of charcoal, set it down on these paver stones, and first of all, just see if we can even run electricity through it at all. All right, here we go. So I'm going to touch one side here, so that's connected, and then theoretically, this electricity should just arc out and straight into the charcoal. Oh, I actually had to get kind of close there, but you can see that is conducting. Very cool. Bring one close, the other close, and now it makes contact, because that has just established a route. Now if I hold it here and try it somewhere else, maybe up here, I have to get within about a quarter of an inch for it to spark up, but then once that connection's made, I can draw the arc out about 2 inches. Now, if I prop these things up and leave them electrically connected to the charcoal long enough, I'm pretty sure we can build up enough heat to get these things to ignite. But before we do, I just want to try another experiment with a few more bricks of charcoal to see if we can get the electricity to hop from one to the other. All right, so I've got a second charcoal briquette set up. The question now is, will it jump the gap between the two? Let's find out. 3, 2, 1, contact. Nope, it doesn't. So we apparently have to start this one off. Let's go ahead and bring this close so we can develop a path. Right there, and then once that's developed, let's see what it does now. Boom, it actually does jump the gap. That's cool. And now we can move these all over the place wherever we want, and it's gonna stay right there in that middle point that's been established. Cool, so apparently 2 works. Let's try 4. There we go. I'm guessing we're gonna have to start these off individually. So get that one going there, get that one going there. Going this way, and this way. Cool. Oh, look at that.
That was cool right there.
So you can see that even though we're using four different briquettes, once we've started them all, they connect very well together with electricity. I can just bring it close and they all connect. They all turn on, they all turn off. They all turn on, they all turn off. And it's starting to smell like really good barbecue because while we've been playing with electricity, these briquettes have absorbed enough heat that they've actually started themselves. In fact, at this stage, we could really just take these briquettes, put them in a grill, and get ready to start cooking hot dogs and hamburgers, which is really cool because we started these things with electricity. Not just any electricity though, high voltage electricity. And that, my friends, is how you start your barbecue like a mad scientist. But here's one more trick. Now, if you want to see an even more fun and slightly dangerous approach, try stacking your briquettes down in the bottom of your grill. Take one of your high voltage electrodes and connect it to the frame. But at this point, you don't want to touch it because if you do, it will shock you. Then if we take the other electrode and put one hand behind our back, we can stick it down inside, draw an arc, and ignite the rest of the briquettes as well. It's certainly not an efficient way to start your barbecue, but you gotta admit it's pretty cool. So there you have it, guys. While my grill is warming up and getting ready for hot dogs and hamburgers tonight, let's recap what we learned here today. We started off this experiment today playing with high voltage electricity and a piece of wood. And what we learned was that wood by itself is not naturally conductive. But if we strike an arc and use that arc to burn the wood, eventually the char will go deep enough to run a carbon arc through the wood itself. Carbon is conductive, and since charcoal briquettes are basically just carbon, we tried an experiment to see if they'd conduct electricity as well, and they did. Now with a fresh charcoal briquette, we brought our high voltage electrodes to the sides, almost to the point of touching. But once they actually struck an arc, we could stretch that arc a couple of inches long. Fascinating. One piece of charcoal worked pretty well, so we brought in another one to see if it would jump the gap, and it did. So we brought in two more, and made a cool little pattern hopping electricity between them all. And in playing with the different designs, we watched the briquettes absorb so much heat from the electricity that they actually started themselves to the point where we could transfer them to our grill and use them to cook our food. So there you have it, guys. That's how to use high voltage electricity to start your grill this summer. Not a very practical or efficient method by any means, but definitely a lot of fun. Thanks for joining me for this experiment today. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Is that cool? Right on. You hear my fingers shocking. Hey, oh, that's dangerous.